Hey guys, it's Green Ninja, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episode 4 of Dr. Elise. So let's go ahead and get started in 3, 2, 1, go. That's because she is. Already? It's like an asthma attack. Just trust her. He'll die. Just do it. He's okay now. Once again, she knows her stuff. Right? You did good. Don't listen to them. How do you know? Just ask her. That's blood. She knows. Let her do this. So that's what she used. At least we're getting to see what happened. We have to at least try. She will. You're right. This is exactly why I could not work in the medical field. I couldn't do it. I can sit and watch like bones and everything being popped out, but I don't think I could do it myself. That's too much pressure on a person. Oh. But she did it though. It's not, though. Of course, like, ugh. This is either gonna be really, really good or really, really bad. But the fact is that the prince, disguised himself as someone else, and Randall got hurt. But thank God, due to, her smart thinking, she was able to save someone's life again. Her ability and just everything about her is just so beautifully well done, and I cannot with this character. Like, oh my God. I mean, damn, like, I really love this chick. Like, seriously, she's so always determined and wanting to save someone's life and stuff because of the fact is, once again, I have not been into a situation where as I'm, because I ain't no damn doctor or no nurse, but I have experienced loss just as much as anyone else. And, for doctors and nurses, they, get attached to their patients a lot and such. As my mom, who was a CNA, she does get attached to her patients and stuff. And the one thing that we don't really see on the other side of that is they also cry when they lose a patient and stuff. And so they also, kind of vow to themselves that they don't want to lose another patient like that and such. And so I think even in that moment, ever since episode one, she's been like that. She does not want to lose anyone or anything, even though in the end she lost her life herself, not once but twice. So I love the fact that no matter what, she's like, we need to try. I know what to do. You need to trust me. I understand that you don't want to trust me and such. Not only because of the fact is, like, the fact that she's a woman, but the fact that she knows all this shit and stuff. And so they're all looking at her like, well, how do you know all of this? And thinking of the time of what this was and stuff. Well, yeah, you're a woman. Women can't do this. Women can't do that. Yada, yada, yada. And so even the other doctor talking to, looking at the report and everything, being like, I can't believe this. Like, this is scribbled. This is chicken scratch and stuff. Like, a child wrote this. Like, I can't believe this is true. This didn't really happen. But no, the proof is in the fact is that Randall's still alive, and that if no one else knew what they could do besides her, he would have died. So she is a gift to these people and such. So, I mean, is she going to be exposed about it next week? It's a possibility. I'm a little scared because of the fact is, she's trying to keep it very hush hush, but because of the fact is she wants to save everyone, I get it if she gets exposed next week about it. But who really knows what the heck is going to happen next week? We just got to wait and see. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction review towards episode 4 of Dr. Elise. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Metro Squad. And of course, I will see you guys officially all next Wednesday for episode 5. But until then, I will see you guys all next time. Bye.